But what you gonna tell somebody, I can give it to you. But what you gonna do with it? Joseph, I can give it to you. Find somebody else. Tell them I can give it to you. Don't you do it, don't you do it. Come on, yeah. It's the last time you want to hear this. Yeah, I want you to get it in your mind that I can give it to you. Keep me in the black box. So listen. Without looking, break it down, some of them. Without looking, what's the scripture? 1 Peter. What's the message? That's so gangster. Y'all be seeing. Let's give our music department a round of applause. I can give it to you. But what you gonna do with it? Yeah, that is the kids. I know what I'm doing. Let me pass it. I can give it to you. Ooh, that always sounds so good over here. But what you gonna do with it? Amen. All the kids, stand up. What's your name? Rodney Perkins? What's your name? I can't hear you. Kyle Page. What's your name? What? He's like, I'm skinny. I got warrants. I don't want to talk about it, Pastor. What's your name? Flower. Owen? What's your name? London? What's your name? Elijah? Elijah, what's your name?
Okay, Jordan.
My nephew, I asked, what's up? Speak up, I can't hear you. He said, all right, kids, y'all can go out. Let's hear it for our kids. Y'all can better than that. Make some noise. Come on, you guys. It's cold outside. It's kind of cold outside. You might need that. Make some noise for the babies. They can still hear you. What's the title of the message? The parents to those kids who just stood up and gave me their names. You stand up now. Amen. Listen, watch this. What's your baby's name? Just kidding. You see where you get it from.
Kyle Page.
London and Owen Dixon.
Ryan Moss.
You have your baby, Rodney Perkins. Just kidding.
Yeah.
Just kidding. Ryan, grandkids, Kyle Page, in church.
Amen.
Yeah. How do you think that makes the Father feel?
Well,
I gave you a gift.
Amen.
In your rotten Perkins. Mm. And you bring him back to church.
Come on, amen.
And give him back to me.
Yes.
And watch this. They just joined the church and he asked me, can you baptize me?
Amen.
He did not hurt.
Amen.
Watch this. Baptize me. So what I'm doing is trying to arrange that at our New Year's Eve service, we be able to baptize since we're going to be in Inglewood.
Amen.
And why not baptize him this year before we go into it? This will make sense to you. If you allow it, I can give you this gift for what you're going to do.
Come on.
You can sit down. Your son, he just can't. Amen. But Kenny is a blessing from God. I don't care where his daddy is. I don't care if y'all don't get along or if you do. I don't care what the situation is. He's still a blessing. Right? So what we do is Satan will come in. And what Satan does, mommy, is Satan will allow some situations to not line up the way that we want them to line up. And then we fall into the situation and we get stuck in the situation, forgetting about the gift in just Kenny.
Yeah.
Amen. And so then now all Kenny feels, not literally Kenny, but people feel who have parents that are fighting over them, is that I am the problem. Hence, I'm going to go find friendship in the hood. I'm going to go find friendship in the weed. I'm going to go find friendship in the girlfriend after girlfriend after girlfriend. I can give it to you.
Yeah.
So what you going to do? Your situation cannot be bigger than Kyle Payne. No matter what you're going through.
Amen.
He didn't ask to be here.
Come on.
Amen. There's some things that you're going to see in him that will resemble his falling away.
Amen.
Even though we allow it, we think it's cool, and we even laugh at it. Amen.
Amen.
Something is different about the power of
age.
Amen. Amen. He's absorbed some stuff. He's holding some stuff on them. This might hurt. This might be too much for church. I don't know. We might not need to do this one today. But there's some things that happen. No, it's supposed to be like that. There's some things. That's how it's supposed to happen. That's how you're supposed to take care of. Amen. There's some things that are going on inside. And it's your fault.
Amen. Come on.
Comes from watching you suffer.
Come on now.
Comes from watching you in tears. It comes from
you
not being happy. It comes from my arm hurting.
Yeah.
It comes from situations that you don't speak, but you think they don't see. I can give it to you, but
what you
going to do with it?
You
can sit down. You can sit down, Grandma.
Yeah.
Listen, I'll get back to you. So, that's your baby, huh? No matter what, that's your baby.
Amen.
Amen. When you feel like it or when you don't, that's your baby.
Amen.
When you feel like church or feel like the hood, that's still your baby.
Amen.
That ain't even your biological baby, but that's your baby. I got one.
Amen.
She ain't here, but I got one. Amen. But that's my baby. My little baby will remind me, that's my dad.
Right.
Y'all dad.
Right.
Amen. Amen. Why? Because at the moment that God gave them to me, they became mine. No. Stay. This is for you. It's going to bless you.
Amen.
It's going to bless you. Sit down. This is how you're going to get your help.
Huh.
Let me work.
Come on, man.
That's right now, Lord.
Preach.
Come on now.
It's black, no take back. Whether y'all good or not, that's your baby.
Amen.
If you can't be all the way, don't be none of it, because it's going to confuse the baby.
Amen.
The gift was that they gave the baby to you. God gave the baby to you. I can give it to you.
What you gonna do with it?
Grandma.
Tight.
You're such a nice grandmother. You're such a sweet girl. Can I be honest? In front of you, you don't mind, right?
Amen.
You, when we first started talking, and I first tried to get you to come to the church, What did you tell them? Just you share.
Oh, that I hadn't been in church in years.
Why?
Well, the church that I was going to feel was. Uh-huh.
Go ahead. You wasn't feeling it. And so what happened was, you decided, I ain't gonna do that anymore. That's not the place for me, so I just gave up on church. True? I'm not speaking for you, right? I'm only telling you what she told me, right? What about the fact that I thought that you was worth it enough to give my perfect son for you? Although you don't deserve him, I'm going to give him to pay for a ransom put on your life where Satan was trying to take you out. But I gave up my son so that you can live this life whether you want to serve me or not. I can give it to you. Now see, I gave you mercy over your cancer. What you going to do? I have been everything that you can imagine. A ratchet could be. And I'm saying that with my family in the room. Amen. At a certain point, God said, well, how long do you think I'm going to allow you to make a fool of me? How long are you going to put your relationship before me? How long is it that I'm going to walk around like I didn't give my baby for you to be suffered a terrible, horrible death? I can give you my mercy. I can give you my grace. But what you gonna do with it? It's something we come to church as an afterthought. We come, oh, I feel like singing, I want to, oh God. See, I see him. I'm in the back watching y'all from behind. We've been singing this song for 18 months. Amen. We've been doing it for 18 months. The same old thing. Amen. Then I come to church. I'm probably up before most of you all.
Yes.
On a good day. Yes. Amen. And I drive the van today. I was driving the van. And the wind was blowing. Right? And so, Marcos, this was the first time that I really thank God that we used to be low riders.
Amen.
And we can drive cars that are going all across the road. Amen?
Amen.
I wouldn't want lady to drive a van today. Because that's how hard it was to get through that wind. So this is what I'm thinking. If I don't make it, we don't have speakers. We don't have a board. We don't have some of the stuff that you guys are enjoying now.
Amen.
Right? And we don't have the pastor. So if I wasn't able to get here, is there anybody here that would have preached this message for me? Leah, you?
Yep.
Well, come on. It's your time. I can give it to you.
Well, what you gonna do with it?
Come on, Elizabeth. Come on, man.
You see, Kevin already did praise and worship. What, see, she said, what you want me to tell him?
He's here.
Watch this. So, I'm going to help you here. I told you guys a time ago that my pastorship over this church is 5 years.
Amen.
5 years. I had some people that just lost their religion. Hell, he ain't. 5 years. Somebody asked me why. I'm glad you asked.
Amen.
Because if you seem to think that the only way that you can get a breakthrough is through me, you're out of line.
Amen. Come on, Pastor.
Amen.
Amen.
Any one of you all could be the pastor. Watch this. And I'm not leaving. I'm just going to be the member that sits up under one of you all who are the pastor.
Come on.
Because you can't be an effective leader unless you learn how to follow.
Amen.
I would be a fool to think that the Holy Spirit only speaks to me.
Amen.